Hi, this is Anne with SVG Cut File, and today I'm going to show you how to identify a font in a piece of artwork or a design or even on a website. All right, let's get started. Okay, so I'm out here on pexels.com, which is a free photo website, and I'm really liking this font here. So I'm going to click on this image and make it bigger. And then I'm going to take a screenshot of this on a Mac that's Shift Command 4. And then you just draw around the section that you want. On a Windows machine, there will be another way to take a screenshot, and you can do that, but you need to just get the text that you want. You wouldn't want to take this whole picture, for example. Another option is if you see a book or something and you like the font on that, you can take a picture with your phone and do this same process. And now we want to open whatfontis.com. Another option here is whatthefont.com. Both are pretty good at recognizing. And it's going to ask us to drag or drop our image. So I'm going to go get that, and I'm just going to drag it onto that area. And then it's going to ask us to crop the text. So I'm going to pull this up a little bit and crop it. And then we'll go on to next step. Now over here, we can optimize the image by increasing the contrast. And this is a really good way of doing this because the more white and black it looks, the better, as long as it doesn't get too blurry. I'm gonna knock down the oh, that's really good. And we can also rotate it so it's straight up and down. This is pretty close, so I'm gonna leave it as is. And usually you'll want your text to be black and your background to be white. So I'm gonna choose invert colors here. And that does pretty good. I'll increase the contrast a little bit more. So we're getting pretty close here to solid black letters on a white background. And then we'll choose next step. Now it's going to ask us what letter each of these are. So I'll just type those in. And make sure that you use capitals if it's a capital letter. That'll help it identify the letters. And then we'll go on to the next step. Now it's going to give us some ideas of what this is. It'll always keep it right up here at the upper left, and then we can compare it to these down here. This Document Ultra is pretty close. I'm looking at the R because it has a little rounded edge. It's best to look at a letter that kind of looks different from the rest of the font. Sometimes it doesn't find the exact font, but it usually gets pretty close. I'm liking this here, the Brandon Grotesque Bold. So we can go ahead and download this font. This is a paid font. You can see it's $40 on myfonts.com. So what we can do is search for Brandon Grotesque font alternative. We'll put free alternative actually. And here's an article about similar free fonts, and it's actually from What Font Is, which is where we just were. We can also type custom text in here. So I'm going to type priority, which is what our other word said. And now we can see all the fonts with that. And I'm liking this one right here. Now this one is free for personal use. So you can put this on a t-shirt or something like that just for yourself, but you can't sell something using this font. So we'll go ahead and download this, and it'll come into my downloads as a zip folder. So I'm gonna do show in Finder. And then I'm just going to open this by double clicking. You can also right click and extract all. And this one ends in TTF. So that is the font file. So I can open this with Command O or just double click it and then install. So that's how I go about finding similar fonts to the fonts I see out in the world or just in a photo or something like that. Now there's also a way to find out what these fonts in websites are. And they have to be a live font, meaning you can highlight it like these up here. So to do that, there's an extension called Font Ninja, and it's right up here. This is on Chrome, and this might be available in other browsers, but it definitely works on Chrome. And to install that, you can go to these three little dots over here and then go to More Tools and Extensions. Then come over here to these dots and open Chrome Web Store. Then you can just search for Font Ninja. And here it is right here. So when you click on this, you can add to Chrome right here. I already have it installed. So I'm going to go back to this myfonts.com, and I'm going to click the Font Ninja right up here. It takes it a minute to load, but then we can just hover over a font, and it's going to tell us that it's Rooney Sans. This one up here is Helvetica New. So that's an easy way to identify fonts that are on web pages, but they do have to be live fonts. Alright, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. Thank you!